The 10 Pin Bowling Show is proudly brought to you by Go Bowling Australia at gobowling.net.au.
Welcome to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. We're at Interbowl Campbelltown, where you're watching continuing coverage of the New South Wales versus South Australia Senior State Challenge. Today is match two of the team challenge. I got Brenton Davy. Brenton, welcome.
Thank you very much, Dennis.
So today we're bowling singles as captains versus captains today.
Well, yeah, and the two captains, they want to set an example for their team, so we'll see how we go.
Well, we wish you well.
Thank you.
Bob, welcome back.
Thank you very much.
Last week, you guys, as you mentioned earlier, you guys threw the ball pretty well, just an unlucky break. So it's tied. It's 1-0 to South Australia, but it's anyone's match.
Absolutely, and we've got lots of games to go, lots of room to get out there and get some high scoring, and we'll get this lefty further over to the left side that you can't score.
Well, have you guys shake hands, and I'll send you over to the commentary team.
Thanks very much, Dennis. And welcome back to the 10th and Bowling Show's coverage of the New South Wales versus South Australia Senior State Challenge. It's the battle of the captains. Brenton Davy is up for his first attempt. He will be doing battle with Bob Whybrow from New South Wales. And currently South Australia lead the ledger 1-0. It's my pleasure to welcome Jason Walsh for his second week commentating on the 10 Pin Bowling Show.
Yeah, I got an invite back for another week, so I must have went all right. Oh, he's got away with that shot a little bit inside to be hearing yelling out hold. So.
Oh, yeah. You can see that anguished look upon his face as he's walking back from the approach too. He knows he hasn't got much room to play with.
Yeah, he had that look in his eye when he was getting ready for that shot, and he looks very focused for this match, Brenton, so I'd be expecting a pretty high score from the big fella in this one.
Bob Whybrow acknowledging a bit of camaraderie there.
Yeah, I'm sure these two guys would have played against each other a lot of times over the years, so this should be a good match.
Quite a concentrated look on Bob's face as he approaches the lanes.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Ooh, he's got a bit of love there in the first frame.
I think they both did.
Yeah. If you look at this shot here, it's just a little bit inside, so the ball hits a little bit heavy and trips a four pin out. And I think every bowler loves to see that when they let a bad shot go.
Oh, I love seeing a four pin trip.
It can be the difference between a good day and a bad day, that pin right there.
Well, you know when you start sticking them, you're not in for a very good one. You'll shoot something like a 190 when on another day you might end up with a 240.
Yeah, it's very easy to turn a game around. So Brenton would be really looking to put a good shot in here to get a little bit of pressure on Bob early on in this game.
He does have the privilege of starting first. Must have had a coin toss with that one, and you would think...
Yeah, he's threw that one really good.
That'd be the first one Brenton's won all day. But
he's got to be careful there. He could break his arm with that running into the wall.
He's got the RoboCop wrist action on there, so I think he's safe. Oh, ooh. Almost. We need a bit of a digital ruler there to see how close he gets to the wall, I reckon. 2-2 for Brenton Davy of South Australia.
So Bob's really, you see, he's taking his time here. He's really trying to make sure he puts a good shot in here and stay in the match early on. Oh, it looks good. That ball really reacted up sharp there for Bob. I was really surprised with that. I thought that ball looked really good about halfway down the lane.
It did look good most of the way down, and that's the leave that we were talking about earlier, Jason, that one that just goes slightly high and starts sticking those four pins. He'll want to get his angles just sorted out just slightly so he can get to maximise his pin carry.
Yeah, and by the look of the reaction that Brenton has, a typical left-hander, it's just pretty much throwing it anywhere.
Oh! Just takes out that four-pin there. Oh, just by about the eighth of a ball, I reckon. It didn't have much there. But therein lies the danger of playing straight across the middle of the lane. That's where all the lane conditioner is, and if you don't get it right, the ball could just slide on by.
Yeah, it's picked up a bit more volume of oil and the ball goes a lot straighter through there. So it can be a little bit tricky if you miss your target.
Mr. Davy has the opportunity to really sink the boot in earlier in the game.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, that's probably one of the ugliest balls I've seen getting around for a while too that he's using there. Looks pretty good, that react.
But it looks nice and pretty when he hits the pins. How about that?
Yeah, Brenton's looking pretty good here. He's got a really nice reaction going on. And that ball just smashed all 10 pins there in one hit.
Yeah, entered the pocket in there just nicely and not too much of an angle into the pins, which maximised the carry, saved all the energy in the ball for when it actually hit.
Yeah, Brenton's off the edge of the lane there and he's got a good reaction. It's always pretty good if you can get a reaction where you can get the ball down the lane straighter and get the ball to react up. The ball gets a lot more hitting power.
Which is something Bob's trying to replicate here now.
You see Bob's made an adjustment there off his last shot that went a little bit heavy and the ball hasn't quite hooked back enough. So he's in a little bit of trouble, I'd have to say, by the look of that.
Yeah, he's having a bit of guesswork at the moment and not too sure whereabouts to play the ball, but one would say speed is a factor.
Yeah, for sure.
So you have a look at Bob Whybrow's feet as he comes to the lane.
They were pretty quick, I can tell you that.
Just about runs to the to the foul line, doesn't he?
Yeah, but he gets to the line there. Look, he's really solid at the line. He's got a little bit of a different technique that he uses with a bent arm swing. But at the line, he gets out of the ball at the perfect point with the ball beside his ankle there.
Now, Bob's been at it for quite a number of years, so he's had lots of time to practice that technique. So. Yeah, Brenton having a moment to himself there, deep breath, really trying to consolidate this lead he's built up.
Yeah, if Brenton can get away with a strike here, he's going to be feeling really comfortable for this game. With these one-game matches, it only takes one shot to turn the match right back in the other guy's favour.
Oh. Now, that wasn't an expletive, folks. That was sit.
Yeah, that ball really hooked up high on Brenton there. And he was lucky to get away with just leaving the six-pin.
Now, that reaction there was the reversal of what you saw from Bob a couple of frames back. Just a slightly high pocket hit and leaving the six pin for the left-hander as opposed to the four pin for the right.
Yeah, you see Brenton stepping up here for the spare. He's still using his same ball he used for his strike ball. A lot of players use a plastic ball for their spares where they go straighter, but Brenton shooting across the lane through the oil. He's stayed with the reactive, so he must be going to hook it a little bit across the lane.
Must be very confident in his ability to throw a hook ball straight.
I think there's about 40 years of experience out there, so...
Oh, yes.
He's been doing it for a while.
And that's just Brenton. There, Bob has the opportunity to pull a couple of pins back now. If he can put a strike on the board and double it, he can claw 10 pins back.
Looks like he's making a little bit of an adjustment there with his feet. If you see him looking down, trying to work out where he was going to put his feet.
Playing more middle part of the lane and a bit of success.
Yeah, the ball, he's picked up a little bit going in and picked up a little bit more oil the whole way down the lane, which has kept the ball a little bit straighter and got it back into the pocket.
Lovely. Here's Brenton with Dennis.
I'm here with Brenton Davy. After four frames, the match is extremely tight.
It is tight. Bob made an adjustment there in the fourth. He looks like he's lined up, so I better stay lined up.
Yeah, mate, what ball are you throwing? I haven't seen one before.
That ball is the 900 Global Long Shot. It's a medium condition ball, pearlized, designed for really easy length, but not overly flippy in the back end. Most of the 900 Global range generally, I've got a philosophy of letting the balls have arc and continuation rather than massive amounts of skid flip.
No, I'm just impressed with the roll. So, mate, we'll let you get back to the match and we'll be right back right after the break.
My name is Alan Jones and you're watching the 10-Pin Bowling Show.
Welcome back to the 10-Pin Bowling Show. I'm here with Bob Whybrow. Bob, the match is evenly poised. You're throwing the ball well.
Yeah, thanks, Dennis. I think Brenton's got a little bit better shot on the left-hand side. He's the only left-hand bowler here today. We're all shooting around the same area on the right. But having said that, he's been more consistent than I have at the foul line, so he deserves to be in front at the moment, but not at the end.
Spoken like a true New South Welshman, mate.
Absolutely.
We'll send you back to commentary team.
Thanks, Dennis.
There's some very good words there from Bob, I'd have to say. This match could get a little bit fired up there towards the end of the game.
I love it. Fighting words from the New South Welshman captain.
Yeah, true spirit right there.
Let's see if Brenton Davy in South Australia can just put the score on the board.
He's made a little bit of adjustment off his last shot there by the look of it, and the ball's just hooked up enough to get to the head pin, and it's mixed him up in the corner, and the big fella's really loved that shot, hasn't he?
Wow, really took care of the right-hand side of the pins there, wasn't it? But you're right on the pick-up of movement there. He's decided to move a little bit inboard. He's adjusted to the poor carry in the previous frame.
Yeah, hopefully Bob can step up here and repeat the shot he bowled in the last frame before the break. He bowled the perfect shot, actually. He made a little bit of adjustment, and the ball looked really good down the lane, so he'll be looking to repeat that shot here and put some pressure on Brenton to keep striking and stay in front. Looked like the ball just flowed a little bit wide again there, and just looking at Bob's reaction, his reaction on his face there, he's not real impressed with that shot.
Yeah, it appeared maybe that shot just floated off the hand just a tad, and he didn't have full control over it after he let go of the ball, which sounds obvious, really, but the ball's motion wasn't quite what he wanted.
I'd have to say the game definitely does look easier when you're looking at it on this side of the camera. I'd have to admit,
yes.
I've had a few episodes on the bowling show out here where I've made the game look pretty hard, and that's the way it can happen when you're out there bowling underneath the lights and the cameras. There's no one really there to help you, and the game goes really fast, probably for all your bowlers at home who haven't had a chance to bowl on TV. 1 minute you're in the first frame, and the next minute the game's just about finished, so it is a tough...
Oh, he likes it! He's really fired up now. He's got 5 out of 6. And I'll tell you what, I think New South Wales are in a bit of trouble.
Yeah, this game's looking like it's kind of heading in one direction, which is not the direction I really wanted to see it head in. But Brenton is really bowling a good game here, so you can't take anything away from him. Hopefully Bob can just relax a little bit here with Brenton on the scoreboard getting a little bit away and just let some balls roll off the hand nice and clean, and you never know what can really happen if you can string a couple of strikes together.
It's a better shot.
Yeah.
The ball held its line for a little bit longer, and the ball didn't check up till a lot further down the lane, which is what he's looking to do.
And with that pin reaction there on another day, that would have kicked that out. It's just the way of bowling when you've got a round object hitting 10 other round objects. Some days they fall over and some days they don't.
That's a good way of putting it. It's not a lot of people would think as a bowling pin is a round object, but doesn't have flat edges, does it?
No, that's for sure. But a nice spare there. Nice and easy spare.
Ooh, so at this point in time, South Australia leading New South Wales by 52 pins.
Yeah, Brenton's really kind of doing a little bit easy here. He'll be hoping to step up here and strike out for the rest of the game, actually. Whenever you're bowling on TV and you start off with a good game, you always want to finish it off and look pretty good on camera, I guess you could say.
Oh, look, he'll enjoy it when he's back in the seat next to me.
Especially Brenton with his young fella sitting at home when they sit down and watch this TV show. If he doesn't perform, I'm pretty sure he's going to cop it.
Oh, yes, big time.
And that is just picture perfect right there.
That is a lovely looking shot. It's probably the most I've ever seen a left hander move the ball, with the exception of Tristan Fu. But no, it really looks good going down at the moment. He's got a great reaction to the ball. Ball's reserving its energy for the hook point, and really smashing those pins about. Now, Bob Whybrow, New South Wales, is hoping he can throw a strike here.
Well, that ball's really checked up. He's in a lot of pain, I guess you could say. He's making movements and he can't really seem to find it at the moment. I guess he's probably at the point now where he's kind of hoping for this game to be fast over, I guess you could say. Or there could be a miracle happen and he could get back in it, but it's just the joys of sport, I guess.
Oh, certainly. And look, like you said earlier in the telecast, it doesn't take much for a little gap to be open.
No, that's for sure.
Anyway, enough of that. We'll go down to Dennis, who's got Brenton.
Brenton, seven frames into the match, you're throwing the ball brilliant.
Well, the last 4 or 5 weeks, I've been struggling a little bit. My rhythm hasn't been really good. I was at Reedy Hill during the week and watching the pros. I was watching Mike Fagan, and he just had just such an easy, loose rhythm. And I guess, to a degree, I'm trying to channel that. And all of a sudden, I'm just starting to freewheel a little bit. And it's probably best I've thrown the ball for a while. Helps that, everything seems to match up pretty well for me. So, yeah, quite happy with it at the moment.
Mate, good luck for the rest of the match. It's something else.
Thanks, mate. Thank you.
And we'll be right back after this ad break. Welcome back to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. Bob, you're keeping the game clean. You're in a rhythm a bit.
Yeah, thanks, Dennis. Brenton's got a bit of an area out there. He's got about three or four boards so that he can roll the ball down. Unfortunately, my ball's jumping a little bit, but I'm sparing okay, so we'll just see what happens.
For the kids at home, I mean, obviously you're about to make an adjustment, or you have been making an adjustment. What are you doing?
I'm going to try another ball, to be honest with you. Normally, I'd probably move left with my feet, but because I'm bowling inside already and the outside's jumping, I think I'm going to try a bit stronger ball and get the ball a bit further down the lane.
We'll let you get into the rest of the match. Good luck.
Thanks, Dennis.
And we'll send you back to your commentary team.
Thanks very much, Dennis. And we've got the end of this exciting match between South Australia and New South Wales.
Yeah, Brenton's stepping up here to try and continue his string of strikes along. Yeah, and he leaves a solid 7-pin there.
The first bit of bad luck I've seen the left-hander have in this telecast. It's a clean shot.
Yeah, it looked good off the hand. Looked just as good as all the other shots he's bowled. But, yeah, some days the corner pins fall over for you and other days they don't. I guess if we knew why they stood up, everyone would bowl for 100 every game. But that's just the way it happens. But an easy spare there for Brenton.
Maybe he was due for one. If we have a look at the score sheet, he's had 3 strikes in a row, then a 9 spare. Kind of funny how it all works out like that.
Yeah, we'll see what happens, see if we can get another 3 strikes to finish out this game. But here comes Bob stepping up here. As you mentioned there before, I think he's going to make a little bit of a ball change and just try a little bit, and hopefully he can find something to finish off this game strong.
And let's hope he can, because I'd love to see Bob bowl well. We've seen him bowl well on the telecast before, and I don't think he'd want to go out in a sub-200 performance.
Oh, that was a great shot right there. Yeah, and he'll be really looking to finish off this game strong to get his team a little bit of momentum going into the next matches.
Yeah, playing a little bit inside out there, which seemed to help his ball reaction a little bit. Picked up a little bit of oil at the front of the lane, which has made the ball push a bit further down.
Yeah,
maybe he's found something.
Yeah, well, the look on his face, looking up at the scoreboard there, I think deep inside he might be kicking himself a little bit there, which is normally what happens when you make a ball change and you strike. You wonder why he didn't do it earlier, but nobody's perfect.
Oh, boy, haven't I said that a few times on this telecast? But here comes Brenton now to try and put another strike on the board. Try and nail it for South Australia.
Ooh, another 7-pin.
Now, for those of you who don't know Brenton Davy well, he'd be getting just a tad bit agitated right now.
Yeah, and I dare say if he loses another one in the next frame, we'll probably hear about it for about 6 months right there.
Oh, dear. Oh, let's hope he doesn't leave another one. He's not back-to-back-to-back.
It's all fun and games in the commentary, I guess.
Oh, certainly. I've only had the pleasure of being on the telecast just the once, and I did have a win that day, so I'm happy to be one for one.
I've been on plenty of telecasts where Brenton's been commentating, and I've had bad days. And there's been a few comments to me, so a bit of payback.
This is your chance. Now, Bob has an interesting assignment ahead of him. If he can put two in a row, he might just inject the fear of God into Brenton.
Yeah, it'll make Brenton get up and have to make a good shot in the first shot in the 10th frame.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, he's got a really nice reaction with that bowling ball in the lane. And you see the teammates there have really come to life as well.
Well, that's two in a row, 3 frames 8 and 9 for Bob. Brenton really needs to put down a good shot here to stamp his authority.
Oh, there it is.
Just straighten up the angle just slightly. Little less angle in the back end, and he's kicked out that 7-pin nice.
Yeah, and by the look of the reaction of Brenton there, he really made sure of that shot. He knew that that was a key shot in the match. Even though he was a little bit ahead, he still had to get up and make a good shot to wrap the match up.
And that one there is the game for Brenton Davy in South Australia. The best New South Wales can do is a 226.
Yeah, when Brenton, if he spares this up here, he'll end up with a 237 game, so he's wrapped up the match here.
He knows about it, and he's telling the boys. Yeah, just enjoying this one just a tad, I think. It's been a little while since Brenton's had a win on TV.
Yeah, the old telecast, they can go your way.
Oh.
He's pulling out all the tricks.
And that's how you hit within an inch of your target, folks.
Yeah, I reckon the teammates will be hearing about that one on the drive home.
Just wonder if that ball's regulation size. Maybe that's why he's getting all these strikes. But a 237 for Brenton Davy in South Australia wraps up this one. SA go 2-0 up against New South Welshmen. Bob looking to finish out on a strong note.
Yeah, I think Bob's going to be disappointed at the end of this game after making a ball change there in the 8th frame. And by the look of it, I think he might even strike out here. This ball looks like it's going to knock him over every shot. So
does look really good, doesn't it, when he lets go of the ball. He's just got that nice continuation down lane.
Yeah, but hopefully the New South Wales boys get together after this match and talk about a little bit what Bob's done there on the lane, where he's playing on it, and step up in the next match and go on from there. Oh, another one straight in the pocket.
That's a lovely shot there. Two of the best shots Bob's thrown today.
Yeah, that's just perfect technique there by Bob.
Now for the fill ball of the 10th, and look, he's having a bit of fun on the lanes.
Yeah, I think the boys in the back are letting him know what's going on, which is always a great part of team bowling.
That really is the key, isn't it? Just have fun on the lanes. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, especially when you're out there with your teammates. Even if you're having a bad game, you've got to keep the team morale up.
High shot, carry for 10. Bob Whybrow in New South Wales finishes with a 226, but it's 11 pin short. South Australia go 2 points to 0.
Welcome back to the 10-Pin Bowling Show. You saw a riveting match in the end between Brenton Davy and Bob Whybrow. Bob just went down just by 11. It was a good match.
Yeah, thanks, Dennis. I mean, Brenton's a high-class bowler, and he got away to a good start. I made the move that I said I was going to make in about the 7th frame, moved the board, pushed my target back out to the arrows, and was able to carry. I should have done it earlier.
Well, mate, there's still some matches to go, and this is... You guys are very much in it.
Oh, absolutely right. I mean, Adelaide, South Australian people, the bowlers are sensational. They've always put a good team out, and we're looking forward to a riveting game.
Well, we look forward to seeing you guys in future matches, and see you next week. Brenton, well, you did what you said you're going to do.
Well, I always thought it was up to the captain to, show by example. And, I've got a good reaction out there. I've got a good look, and... When you've got that, you've got to make use of it, because there's plenty of times you'll go out there and you're going to struggle. So, I've got a good look, good reaction, and a couple of good teammates here as well. So, we'll be giving our best shot.
Being in front of the camera is much different than being behind it, isn't it?
Well, yeah, I guess that I've always been a little bit of a show pony, I guess, Yeah, it put me in front of a crowd, and if there isn't a crowd, just give me a mirror.
Fair enough.
To quote Carmen Salvino, but yeah, about the same. I like, yeah, but then again, I put a South Australian shirt on, and it's a bit of a Jekyll and Hyde thing. I go a little bit mad sometimes.
Well, we look forward to seeing you guys in future episodes.
Thanks, mate.
And that'll see the end of us for this episode of the 10-Pin Bowling Show. Please join us again next week for the continuing coverage of the Senior State Challenge between New South Wales and South Australia. From here, everyone here, good luck in high scoring.
The 10-Pin Bowling Show was proudly brought to you by Go Bowling Australia at gobowling.net.au.